In the world of elements, there is one that stands out for its striking color and incredible versatility. It can disinfect wounds, treat life-threatening diseases, and can even be used for controlling the weather. This element is powerful, essential to both human health and technology. Your body needs this element to function. Your brain relies on it to develop, and without it, entire systems can fall into disarray. Today, we talk about the element that you voted for, iodine. Welcome to Cube Chemistry, where we will discuss all the elements of the periodic system and also do experiments. And if you like these videos and want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Meet iodine, and it is indeed an interesting element. As you can see, it is dark red, almost violet in this cube. The reason is that they put mineral oil in it to let its color stand out. As you can see, it is a solid, and iodine is element 53 on the periodic table, part of the halogen family and also known as the salt makers. Now, what was that again? Well, this is group 17 of the periodic table, and they earned the name salt maker because when they react with metals, they form ionic compounds that are called salts. Iodine has 53 protons and 53 electrons and only one stable isotope, iodine 127. Now, iodine at room temperature will sublimate. Now, what is that? Elements tend to go to different states from solid to liquid and from liquid to gas. Also, this can go the other way, from gas to liquid and from liquid to solid. These changes can be forced when changing the pressure or changing the temperature. Now, there is also sublimation. This is the process where a solid will immediately turn into gas. And this is what happened to iodine at room temperature at a very slow rate. But does this also mean that iodine can't melt? No, that is not what it means. Iodine can melt at 114 degrees Celsius, even though some textbooks try to tell us that it can't. Now, in order to show you that iodine can melt, you can watch the video of Niall Redd about this topic called The Iodine Myth. I will leave a link in the description. Now, you might have seen iodine before in its dark violet form, but have you ever wondered why sometimes it looks like a liquid? Well, that's because iodine crystals are often stored, like here, in mineral oil, a substance that is not only preserving the iodine, but also enhances its deep violet color. Interestingly, the name iodine comes from the Greek word iodis, meaning violet-like, because of the vibrant hue of its crystals and vapor. The story of iodine dates back to 1811, when French chemist named Bernard Courtois accidentally discovered it while experimenting with seaweed. While he was extracting potassium and sodium from seaweed ash, he accidentally added too much sulfuric acid. A violet-colored cloud evolved from the mass, and the resulting gas was condensed into dark crystals. And this was the first occurrence of observed solid iodine. Another fun fact: pure iodine is poorly soluble in water, but if you add an iodine salt, such as sodium iodine or potassium iodide, it dissolves well by bonding with the iodine ion to form iodine 3. This triiodide ion is something of a curiosity because, according to conventional chemical bonding theory, iodine has a valency of 1, meaning it should only bond with one other atom. On top of that, we're talking about a negative ion here of iodine, and that has a noble gas configuration, like xenon. So it should theoretically have a valency of 0. This is known as a hypervalent bond, similar to what we see in xenodefluoride. One of iodine's most common uses is as disinfectant. You've probably seen that brown-red solution applied to cuts or in surgeries. It's iodine. Its ability to kill bacteria makes it a go-to for cleaning wounds and preventing infections. We also use iodine in the functioning of halogen lamps, not for the light itself, but to make sure that the tungsten can reach higher temperatures. These higher temperatures make it possible for the light to burn brighter. In these bulbs, iodine gas interacts with the tungsten filaments to produce bright, long-lasting light. When the filaments heat up to a scorching 3000 degrees Celsius, a bit of tungsten evaporates and reacts with the iodine, forming tungsten iodide. As the compound moves back to the filament, it breaks down again, returning the tungsten to the filament and allowing the process to repeat itself, creating a light that lasts longer and shines brighter than traditional incandescent bulbs. But perhaps one of the most critical roles iodine plays is in medicine. Radioactive isotopes of iodine, particularly iodine-123 and iodine-131, are used in treating thyroid conditions, including cancer. The thyroid gland naturally absorbs iodine, so these isotopes deliver targeted radiation to destroy cancer cells, offering a powerful treatment option. There is also a connection between nuclear accidents and iodine. During nuclear accidents, radioactive iodine is released in the atmosphere, posing a serious health risk to anyone nearby. Since iodine accumulates in the thyroid, exposure to radioactive iodine can lead to severe complications. To counter this, people in affected areas are often given iodine tablets. These tablets flood the thyroid with non-radioactive iodine, preventing the absorption of the harmful isotopes and reducing the risk of radiation poisoning. Iodine can even influence weather. In a process called cloud seeding, tiny crystals of silver iodide are released into the atmosphere to encourage rain formation. This method has been used in places like China, Dubai, India, and many other places to increase rainfall in arid regions. But it's not without risks. In 2021, an overzealous attempt to create rain accidentally caused massive flooding in the city of Dubai. It is important to note that when you play with rain, make sure that your sewers can handle it. Yet, despite its many technical applications, iodine's most vital role is in our own bodies. The human body needs iodine, especially in the thyroid gland, which uses it to produce hormones that regulate metabolism and brain development. Iodine deficiency can lead to serious health problems, including thyroid disorders and development delays in children. That's why iodine is often added to table salt, so people can get enough in their diets. Sprinkling a little iodized salt on your food isn't just about seasoning. It's a way of ensuring your body that it gets this essential nutrient. In fact, iodine deficiency affects nearly 2 billion people worldwide, especially in regions where the soil lacks natural iodine. Without enough iodine, the thyroid gland can't function properly, leading to conditions like goiters and development issues in children. Another thing that you can use iodine for is as an indicator to detect starch. A solution of iodine that you make so diluted that it's barely pink turns dark blue in the presence of starch. Now, a friend of mine told me that when he did his chemistry studies, he once had to do an experiment to measure the activity of saliva in breaking down starch at various temperatures and pH levels. They used iodine to see how long it took for all the starch to disappear. So from disinfecting wounds, lighting up homes and controlling the weather, to treating cancer and supporting brain development, iodine plays a role in more parts of life than we often realize. This tiny crystal holds a world of possibilities and is crucial to our everyday well-being. Whether it's in your salt or your medicine or even in the light above you, iodine is a small element with a massive impact on our world. So next time you see the purple glow, remember the story of iodine. Now, if you think I forgot something, make sure to put it in the comments. And if you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Make sure also to fill in the poll on our community site so you can choose the element that we will discuss next week. The poll will close on Friday. See you next week.